Hello all, welcome to this video on microprocessors and microcontrollers. The topic we are discussing today is interrupt cycle of 8086 or 8088. Let's begin. What is an interrupt? As you can see from the picture, an interrupt means to break a sequence of an ongoing operation. While the CPU is executing a program, an interrupt breaks the normal sequence of execution of instructions, diverts its execution to some other program that we call ISR or interrupt service routine. After executing ISR, the control is transferred back to the main program, which was being executed at the time of interruption. Broadly, there are two types of interrupts. The first of them is the external interrupt and the second one is internal interrupt. In external interrupt, an external device or signal interrupts the processor from outside, or in other words, the interrupt is generated outside the processor. For example, a keyboard interrupt. The internal interrupt, on the other hand, is generated internally by the processor circuit or by the execution of an interrupt instruction INT. The example of this type are divide by zero interrupt, overflow interrupt, interrupts due to INT instruction, etc. Next, let us see the interrupt cycle of 8086 or 8088. First of all, let us see what NMI is. NMI is a pin signal of 8086, which is pin number 17, and it stands for non-maskable interrupt and is one of the hardware interrupt pins. Suppose that an external device is interrupting the CPU at the interrupt pin, and it can be either the NMI or the INTR pin, which are the 17th and 18th pins of the 8086, while the CPU is executing an instruction of the program. The CPU first completes the execution of the current instruction. The instruction pointer is then incremented to point to the next instruction. The CPU then acknowledges the requesting device on its INTA pin immediately if it is an NMI, trap or divide by zero interrupt. Now, INTA pin is pin number 24 of 8086 during the minimum mode, and it is an active low signal. If the request is an INT request, then the CPU checks the IF flag. Now, IF flag stands for interrupt flag, and it corresponds to bit number 9 of the flag register of 8086. If this interrupt flag is set, then the interrupt request is acknowledged using the INTA pin. If the interrupt flag is not set, then the interrupt requests are simply ignored. Also note that the responses to the NMI, trap and divide by zero interrupt requests are independent of the interrupt flag. After an interrupt is acknowledged, the CPU computes the vector address from the type of interrupt that may be passed to the interrupt structure of the CPU internally, as in case of software interrupts, NMI, trap and divide by zero interrupts, or externally, that is from an interrupt controller in case of external interrupts. What happens here is the contents of instruction pointer and code segment register are next pushed into the stack. The contents of instruction pointer and code segment register now point to the address of the next instruction of the main program from which the execution is to be continued after executing the ISR. The PSW or program status word is also pushed into the stack. The interrupt flag is cleared and the TF flag or the trap flag is cleared after every response to a single step interrupt. Here, T flag corresponds to bit number 8 of the flag register of 8086. Here from the diagram, you can see that an interrupt type N, that is INTN, will contain, INTN request will contain IP, CS and PSW values. So these will be pushed into the stack from the lower byte. So first IP is pushed, then CS and then PSW. So after each push, the stack pointer will be decremented by 2 because each of these values contain 2 bytes. And then the control is transferred to the interrupt service routine to serve the interrupting device. And the new address of the ISR is found out from the interrupt vector table. Thus, the execution of ISR starts. If further interrupts are to be responded to during the time the first interrupt is being served, then the interrupt flag should be set to 1 by the ISR of the first interrupt. If the interrupt flag is not set, the subsequent interrupt signals will not be acknowledged by the processor till the current one is completed. The programmable interrupt controller is used for managing such multiple interrupts based on their priorities. At the end of an ISR, the last instruction should be IRET, which stands for return from interrupt. When the CPU executes this, the contents of flags, instruction pointer and code segment register, which were saved at the start of the call instruction, are now retrieved to the respective registers and the execution continues from this address that is received by IP and CS. Now let us see how 8086 or 8088 finds out the address of an ISR. Every external and internal interrupt is assigned with a type N, as shown here, that is either implicit, as in case of NMI, trap and divide by zero, or specified in the instruction INT space N, as in case of internal interrupts. In case of external interrupts, the type is passed to the processor by an external hardware like the programmable interrupt controller. In the 0th segment of physical address space, that is for which the value of CS is 0000, Intel has reserved 1024 locations for storing the interrupt vector table. The 8086 supports a total of 256 interrupts, that is from 00H to FFH. Each interrupt require 4 bytes, that is 2 bytes for each of instruction pointer and code segment register address of its ISR. Thus a total of 1024 bytes are required for 256 interrupt types. Hence, the interrupt vector table starts at location 0000:0000 and it ends at 0000:03FFH. The interrupt vector table contains the instruction pointer and code segment register address of all the interrupt types stored sequentially from the address given below. The interrupt type N is multiplied by 4 and its hexadecimal multiplication obtained gives the offset address in the 0th code segment at which the instruction pointer and code segment register addresses of the interrupt service routine are stored. The execution automatically starts from this new CS:IP. That's all for now. Thank you. Thank you for listening.